and welcome back. Now that the fin is ready, I can move on to digitizing the body of the seahorse. I'm going to hit the minus key a few times to zoom out so I can see my artwork better. The body of the seahorse is made up of six long and narrow objects. The best tool to digitize those is the Digitize Blocks tool. So I'm going to move over to Toolboxes, expand the Digitize toolbox and select Digitize Blocks. When you use this tool, you actually have to click from one side to another rather than going along one side of the shape of the object. And again, you use right clicks for curved points and left clicks for straight points. If you make a mistake by clicking on the wrong side, you can always hit the backspace button, backspace key on your keyboard, and then just continue. So I'm going to quickly do this object, just down to about here. I'm going to finish here, and I hit enter. So now you can see that this is quite a dense stitch, so I'm going to select the object, right click, bring up object properties, and I'm going to apply a few effects. So I'm going to do feathered side to both sides, and I'm going to apply a gradient fill using profile 3. I'm also going to remove all underlays. I want this to be really light. I'm going to change the color to the navy blue. And you can see that there's a line here, so that's a round stitch, and that's because the start point and the end point of the stitching hasn't been set up properly yet. So I'm going to hit reshape, and I'm going to find the start point, which is this, oops, not like that. I need to grab this green diamond here, and I'm going to put it right here on the top of the shape. The end point, which is symbolized with this red cross, is sitting in the right spot, right at the very end, so that's fine. I'm going to hit select again. And I'm going to quickly actually digitize another block. I'm going to start it from about here. And I'm going to overlap this block to start building up that gradient shading effect. Keep using the right mouse click for curved points. I'm going to go a little bit further down this time. I'm going to finish it right about here. Again, I need to do the same things, so I'm going to select it and go to effects, both sides feathered and the gradient fill, choose profile 3 and remove all underlays. Do the same thing, make sure that the end start point and the end points are in the right spots. Here we go. Select, and I'm going to change the color to the slightly lighter blue, this royal blue here. Quickly show you another one. So when you do this, you make sure that you overlap your object. You can always edit it by using the reshape tool. But you just roughly want to get it right. Select. Remove underlays. Really, the order is not important. And ensure that the start and the end points are in the right spot. Here we are. Do remove any round stitches and change the color to this. Now I've got all six objects of the body digitized. If I open the resequence docker, you can see them all here. You can also see that there's quite a lot of overlap to create that gradient shading effect. I'm going to move on to digitize the face. So I'm going to hit the B key and zoom in on the face. I'm going to move it slightly here. Don't need this now. I'm going to open the Digitize toolbox and select Digitize Close Shape. Doesn't have to be exact. It's quite a rough sort of design. I'm going to just go around the eye now. A little bit further up here. Hit enter. I'm going to go and reshape. Grab the stitch angle handle and move this up here. I'm going to hit select again. Open up object properties. And I'm going to apply the effects. Remove the underlays, and here we are. I'm going to digitize one more shape because I need at least two layers for the face. Doesn't have to be exactly on the top. Going to hit reshape again, and this time I'm going to change the stitch angle to the opposite direction. Apply the effects, and I'm going to change the color of this object. The smaller one to this color, and the bigger one to this color. To this blue color. So now if I zoom out, the body and the head of the seahorse is ready. Thank you for watching.